Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahi walhamdulillahi wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulihi Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. We always praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We send blessings and salutations upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his entire household, his companions. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless them, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless each and every single one of us. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the favors he has bestowed upon us and for choosing parents for us who he has granted the ability and the right to take care of us right from childhood up to the point of when we grow. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for having chosen the best of people for us to take care of us and to act as our parents, and which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expects from them to bring us up the way he wants and not the way they want. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided and he chose a dad and a mom for each and every single one of us, and then he brought us to the earth through them. So we love them for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we really pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants them Jannah, and we really ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to continue to bless them. But of course it is very, very important that we go through a very, very important topic and a very, very important aspect of our lives, and this has to do with the marital life that is to be there between the husband and the wife. And not just that, but most especially when it comes to the children, and then how the children should be brought up in Islam, and then how they should be brought up according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has allowed and what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught. Because really this generation is a time where if parents are not told what is meant to be, sadly they would think the only way they can bring up their own kids is to bring them up the way they were brought up, and sadly it may not necessarily apply in this generation. So when we talk about the change in terms of generation, so many things have changed, but these things that have changed doesn't mean that they are against the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Actually they are all everything the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught, and in this generation it is very, very important for the parents to apply this if really, really they want to bring up their kids in a beautiful way upon the teachings of Islam, and if they really want to see that their kids grow up to be very, very responsible, respectful and God-fearing children. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for our parents. وَقَدَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرُهُمَا وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has dictated and declared that none shall be worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that for the parents we should be kind upon them. And if any one of us were to witness one or both of the parents alive up to the point of old age, we shouldn't say uff to them. Uff is an Arabic statement of disrespect. We shouldn't say uff to them, and we should not repel them. We shouldn't be disrespectful to them. Allahu Akbar. And then the ending part of the verse says we should talk to them in a respectful way. We should use words that are kind, words that are respectful, words that parents are meant to have from us, because really the next verse talks about beautifully as well, the parents as well. واخفض لهما جناح الذل من الرحمة وقل رب ارحمهما وقل رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. And then lower to them the wing of mercy. Lower to them, the parents, the wing of mercy. And then you should pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O my Lord, have mercy on them just like they brought me up. Have mercy upon them because they are the ones that brought me up. Imagine we've started very beautifully to say these verses are talking about the respect and the kindness the parents deserve from us. But it is very, very important also for the parents to realize that when they command us and instruct us to do things that are besides what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has allowed us to do, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do not obey them.
وَإِن جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا وَصَاحِبَهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا.
And then when they call you or invite you to do something that is besides what Allah has allowed you to do, which you have no knowledge of then, فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا, do not obey them. Imagine all these verses, all the verses that are talking about parents, everywhere you see, they talk about be kind to them. Then when it has to do with something that has to do with respect or obeying them, the verse says, do not obey them. Allahu Akbar. Yet sadly, today it has become a very, very huge and big problem that parents want to do things the way they want, and they want to force their kids to do everything that is besides what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has allowed them to do. My beloved parents, we need to understand. Now I want to go through the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the beauty of an Islamic home and the beauty of an Islamic family and the beauty of how we should understand the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, khayrukum khayrukum li ahlihi wa ana khayrukum li ahli. The best from among you are those who are best to their spouse, and I am the best from among you to my own spouse. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The best from among you is one who is best to his spouse. And I am the best from among you to my own spouse. This is what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said. Now, if we go through the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I think the sound is better, right? Is it better now, the sound? Now, if you go through the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, everything we need or the parents need in order to bring up their own children is in the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But sadly, the parents want to apply everything that perhaps was applied to them when they were being brought up. And sadly, like I said, in this generation, it may not apply. Now, so many families are breaking. So many kids are falling into big problems. So many kids are becoming more and more distant from their parents. Why? One of the reasons is because there is lack of communication, there is lack of interaction, there is lack of relationship between the parents, which the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to have. Allahu Akbar. Sadly, now everything has changed. The dad comes home, he knocks on the door, Assalamu alaikum. He enters the home. He sits in the parlor, the sitting room, he sits on the chair. He would never talk to the wife. I'm just like confused every time I see things like this. It's like, did you marry her to watch her alone? Subhanallah, so the dad comes home, he sits on the chair, he grabs the newspaper. Okay, before it was the newspaper, then it became the TV, now it is the phone. So the dad comes home, he sits on the chair, where are you? Come here, where's the food? The food is not ready. The food is not ready? Why are you wasting my time? Bring the food, man. He starts shouting. This is what is happening today. So it has become such that, sadly, there's no interaction between the dad, the mom, the children, and the home is just like that. And the kids grow up to see this, and they as well, when they grow up, they may want to marry and do the same with their kids. And wallahi, it will never ever help them. Like I said, children are falling into big, big problems today. They are becoming more and more distant from their parents. Why? Because the dad is meant to be feared. That is what the dad thinks. The dad is meant to be feared. That is what the dad thinks. Well, I want the parents to think about this, and they should understand there is a difference between fear, respect, and love. When your son fears you, he would never ever do anything wrong when you are there. But imagine he's going to do everything wrong when you are not there. And I know of so many examples. The dad comes and he shouts, "I don't play with my kids. You don't know me. I discipline them. They fear me." And wallahi, his kids are taking shisha behind his back and he doesn't even know. I imagine what he's going to do when he comes to know about this. Allahu Akbar. It's better for you to have a relationship with your kids and they fear you out of love and respect, but not out of you're gonna beat them up or shout at them. What is the use of them fearing you and they keep on fearing you and they are doing everything wrong behind you, and when you are there, they just become hypocrites. Allahu Akbar. It's better for them to be proud. They can come to their dad and tell them, "Dad, I've done something wrong. Advise me." The kids can't talk to the dad. They can't do anything. They are scared. They can't seek for advice. When the son wants advice, they end up going to Google. They end up going to every other thing. And there is no just relationship in the home. I want the parents to understand something else. Now, when you tell the parents, "My beloved dad, my beloved mom," you need to start becoming more kind and close to your kids. Then they begin to think, "Well, if I become more kind and close to my kids, I'm going to spoil them. If I spoil them, they would become disrespectful. They would become spoiled kids." Wallahi, it is not spoiling. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had the best relationship with his wives, and yet they lived a simple, simple life. In the narration, it comes that they spent so many months without food in the home, only water and dates. Allahu Akbar. Yet the parents think, "If I become kind to my kids, they are going to become disrespectful." No, they are not going to become disrespectful. It is you that needs to become patient, and you need to talk to them in a very, very kind and respectful way so that they understand and realize that you love them. Do you tell your kids you love them? You don't. Do you call them? Do you pray for them? You don't. "Yes, I pray for them." They mustn't know I am praying for them. Call them and tell them you are praying for them. Let them know. Let them see. You are the ones who brought the TV into your home. You brought the phone into your home. You have the Wi-Fi inside your home. 24/7, everything is there. And you have all these dirty channels going in your home. And they see all these actors and actresses. They're all kissing each other, hugging each other, kissing their kids. And how do you want your kid's brain to be cool and soft when he sees this on the TV and then he doesn't get that from you? It's not possible. It's not possible, wallahi. You've left them at a level that, let's say, it's 10 out of, let's say, 20. You show them 10 love out of 20. And then you let them have this TV and they see 18 out of 20. How do you want them to be happy? They would never ever be happy because they see something that is better than what they are having and they want to have what they are seeing, but sadly they can't have it. How do you want them to be happy? Wallahi, they cannot. And that's why they can't share with the parents any of their problems. They won't be able to share these problems. Well, we need to look into the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then we would understand how we should be living with the wives, the mothers of the children. You come into your home, you wake up for Salatul Fajr, smile, wake up, go and wake up your kids. Wake them up every day for Salatul Fajr. If you don't do this, this is one thing you need to start. After Salatul Fajr, you go to the mosque together, perhaps. Then after Salatul Fajr, you come back home. You may want to start doing certain things like a recitation of the Quran with your kids. You sit them down, you recite Quran with them. When you finish, you tell them to ask you questions. This is a wise way of starting to build relationship and interaction with your kids in a beautiful and in an Islamic way. After Salatul Fajr, you read the Quran together with all of them and you tell them to ask you questions. And then after you pray for them, you've done one thing. You are beginning to change your home. Number two, if you've never eaten breakfast with your kids, this is the right time for you to start eating breakfast with your kids. You sit them down. You sit and eat breakfast all together with them. And you tell them, my children, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he taught, before you start eating, you say basmala. After you finish eating, you say this and you eat with them. And you pray for them after eating. Allahu Akbar. The family is beginning to change. Then maybe for Salatul Zuhr and Salatul Asr, you've gone for a walk, then the mom can take over there. She may stay with them, give them stories, or teach them so many things. Then when you come back at night, I know of so many families, the dad thinks at night, it's already night time. You know what's there? I'm going to wear my t-shirt and my shorts. I'm going to come to sleep. No. You need to start changing that. Go and look for a good clothing that you have. Wear the clothing, it should be ironed. Wear a nice cap, spray the perfume. Let you come back home and the children see you. Because right now the children already have a mentality that my parents only dress up when they want to go for an outing, or when it is Friday, or they want to go for a wedding, or they want to go to the workplace. When they are at home, it is t-shirt and boxers and shorts. Allahu Akbar. The Prophet used to dress up for his wife. Start dressing up. Wear a beautiful clothing. Wear the cap. Wear the perfume. Come back home and you are scenting so nice. And then you come back home, you eat dinner with your kids as well. You teach them the dua as well before and after eating. And after, you may want to recite Quran again, or perhaps tell them stories. You are beginning to change your home. Every day before your kids go to school, if you are there, you pray for them and then you let them go back to school. When they come back to school, you ask them, what have you learnt in school? We never ask our children what they learnt in the school. And when they fail, how did you get an F9? Did I take you to school to go and fail? You never spoke to him. You never spoke to him. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Wallahi, the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is just the best. That's why he said, khayrukum, khayrukum li ahlihi, wa ana khayrukum li ahli. The best from among you are those who are best to their spouse, and I am the best from among you to my own spouse. Be good to your families.
Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara.
Oh, you who believe, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, save yourselves and your families from the fire. This is all we are talking about, my beloved parents. They need to understand. Wallahi, kids are getting lost. A lot of them at this point and stage, they are fed up of staying in the home. And all they want to is, I want to grow up. You know what? I want to finish secondary school. I want to go to the varsity so that I can become free. I can do what I want. As it is, I am fed up of this house. Nobody cares about me. Any small thing, they shout at me. They beat me up. I don't even like this house. And this is everything they always say. And you don't even know about it. Wallahi, if there's a good relationship between you and your kids, you are safe. You are safe. The kids are too shy and too scared of the parent, to the extent that the kids cannot even relate the good things with the parent. Allahu Akbar. They are too scared. They can't relate good things. They can't relate bad things. So what should they do? They score 5/5 in the classwork, they can't show you. They fail, they can't show you. What do you want them to do now? Because they are too scared. They are too scared. I want the parent to understand, like I said, when you begin to become kind to your kids, it doesn't mean you are going to spoil them. Wallahi, when they know you love them, even if you tell them, you know what, we are going to begin to start eating 2 meals a day, wallahi, they would be happy. It's out of love. It's better for you to have 2 meals seated with your kids than to let's reward it. It's better for you to have 2 simple meals with your kids than to have 5 delicious and expensive meals without your kids. Because the first two, there is interaction. There is the beauty of the family. It is there. We need to understand this. The kids, they have WhatsApp, they have everything. La ilaha illallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us. Your kid has a phone, you bought the phone for him, he has WhatsApp, he has blocked you on WhatsApp. Have you realized? You may not know. I am telling you because I am in the picture and I know what is happening. He must have blocked you perhaps on WhatsApp. You don't see his status. Why? Because I don't want him to even have anything to do with me. He mustn't know what I'm in, what I'm not in. I don't care. I'm going to block him on WhatsApp. I block my dad. I block my mom. I block the uncle, the auntie. I block everyone. And only my friends can see my status. Allahu Akbar. Why? Because, subhanallah, the relationship is very far and they are scared. There's no interaction. Subhanallah. There's no interaction in the home. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us. So the parents, it is something that needs to start happening between the dad and between the mom so that the kids can see. And then when they see, there would be a better family. And then the issue of the television is there as well. The TV is inside the home 24/7. So you ask the boy, who is the best friend of your child? It is the TV. The best friend of your child, it is the PlayStation. They don't want to talk to you. They don't want to go outing with you. Imagine, how can your kids be scared when you come back home? As soon as you, subhanallah, as soon as you leave home, they are happy. Everybody's playing, everybody's smiling, everybody's joking. Beep! He's back. The boss is back. Everybody's scared. They throw this, they even throw sometimes the Quran, they throw everything. They throw even the good things they are doing because the fear is too much. The fear is too much. Imagine you come back and they are even more happy. They are waiting for you at the door. You come in, they collect your bath, they take everything for you, they sit down, they greet you, they wait for you. They are waiting for you to come back because they know when you come back, you are going to have dinner with them. But no, when you come back, everybody hides and you are happy. I always wonder how the parents are happy when the kids are scared of them, especially the dads. You are happy when they are hidden. You don't see anything and you are more happy. When they are there, you are sad. Allahu Akbar. It is only when you see them that you even know what is going on. But no, you are happier when they see you and they hide. So here the parents are the ones that are going to help the kids to ensure that they show them love in such a way, the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because this generation, I tell you, it's very easy for your child to begin to think, I want to quickly run out of this home because they are all making my life difficult. If you want to help your own child, if you want to help your own child, then this is the right time for you to spend time with them, to teach them the deen, to teach them Islam, spend time with them, teach them the Quran, have meals with them, pray for them, tell them you love them, you care for them, you pray for them, and they hear you pray for them. And this is the only way you are going to help them, because really, if you don't establish a connection and the relationship with them right now, when they grow up, it becomes too late because you cannot control them anymore. So this is the best time. Even when they grow up, they want to meet you. Dad, I want to get married. They talk to you in a respectful way, but you never had a relationship with them. You didn't used to speak to them. You never told them anything. They were scared of you. Now they want to marry and you think you want to advise them and you want them to follow your advice. They would not follow your advice because right from the beginning, right from young age, they were already wishing and praying, oh Allah, I want these 10 years to come very quickly so that I can do what I want. But imagine they are waiting for the 10 years to come so that they can do something to make you happy, or so that they think, man, when I want to get married, I'm going to seek for my dad's advice. I know he would advise me in a beautiful way. He would love me more, but not anymore. Today, they want to quickly grow up, marry someone who you don't decide and leave the home very quickly. They are tired of you. Allahu Akbar. You want to save your kids. This is the right time for you to establish the relationship. This is the best time. Help your kids. This is the right time for you to help them. Spend time with them. And then you would be able to save them from this generation because I tell you, it's becoming more and more difficult. more and more difficult. I know of so many cases, children, you ask them, I want to leave the home, I'm tired, my mom, she doesn't even know, my dad, he doesn't even know, they don't have time for me, I really don't understand them, they don't understand me, see, I just want to leave the home. What is happening? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not like that. Khayrukum khayrukum li ahlihi wa ana khayrukum li ahli. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the best from among you is one who is best to his spouse, husband to wife, wife to husband, and I am the best from among you to my own spouse. This is what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. We need to try our best. We gave examples of how a beautiful family should be like from the morning till night time. How you should spend your time with your kids gradually. You have breakfast with them. You teach them dua for breakfast before and after breakfast. You have lunch with them if you are there. If you are not there, you wait when you come back from home, from your workplace. You ask them how was school. You teach them. They seek advice from you. They are open. They are okay. They would come and meet you for advice when they make mistakes. But when they are scared, they would never ever let you know what they are into. I know of so many parents, like I gave their example. You don't know me. I discipline my children. I don't play with them. Wallahi, your son is there taking shisha every Saturday and Sunday. You don't know about it. Yeah, you discipline the boy. You don't know. He's disciplining you actually. Subhanallah, subhanallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our parents and make everything easy for them. And we as well have to become kind to our parents. We have to become kind to them. When they tell us to do something that is against what Allah has allowed us to do, we beautifully talk to them. We beautifully tell them, my mom, my dad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want this. Now I want to quickly go through what happens when there is no good relationship between the dad and the mom, between the husband and the wife. And I know of thousands, okay, not thousands, let's be realistic, so many cases, subhanAllah, so many cases when you don't have a relationship with your own wife. When you don't have a relationship with your own wife, you're always home. You just demand for food and you watch the TV, you watch your phone, you watch her, she brings the food, you eat the food, you go to bed next morning, you wear my water, I want to take my bath, she brings the water, you take your bath, you wear your clothes, you go for a walk, you come back, and that is the life. If that is the life, you are risking your own life, you are risking the life of your wife, you are risking the iman of your wife, because I tell you, those friends of hers are going to come, and I know of so many cases. You know what, my sister, I want to tell you. You see, this husband of yours, there are so many things we have to do about him, because if you don't, you see, he doesn't spend time with you. He's always out for work. You ask him for money, he doesn't give you. You know what? There is that sheikh. We're going to go and meet that sheikh. He's going to help you. Then the sheikh tells you, you know what? We're going to give you this. Before your husband, wallahi, I'm very realistic here, because I know of so many cases, and we want to help the husbands and the wives as well. That is why we are talking about this. You know what? Okay, your husband, you know, we're gonna give you this powder. Before he takes bath, make sure you pour it inside the water he wants to bath with. Before he takes tea in the morning, make sure you pour the powder in the tea before he takes the tea. When you begin to do this, he will start loving you. Okay, you see this? You have to go to the back of your home. You have to bury this and you have to do. It never ever solves the problem. Rather, sometimes it makes the problem less, but it never goes. And the problem that can be solved in a very small communication, you are wasting your iman, you are wasting your money, you are going perhaps into shirk, and so many people are at risk. Something that can just be solved when there is an understanding between you and your husband, none of this would ever happen. There is love, there is communication, there is interaction. You seek for each other's advices and you speak to one another. She knows you love her, he knows, vice versa, subhanAllah. No one is gonna come and convince her. But when the relationship is far, then she's going to be doing things. I want to catch my husband. They say if I put this, it would. And really, shaitan would start making it look beautiful. You know, when you start putting the powder inside the tea, next morning he comes, he's smiling. When he takes water with the, he takes bath, his bath with the water, with the powder inside. Next morning he's smiling and you think everything is working. It's all shaitan's plan. Shaitan is a master planner, you don't know. He's very good at his plans, you'd never know. Simple thing we are meant to do, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so many examples. Aisha radiallahu anha, she said the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, amazing, amazing, amazing. When she took something inside the cup, she drank it, he would pick the cup, turn the cup to where she had put her mouth on, and you put his mouth on that same place, and you'd blush, and she'd see that, and you'd drink from that. Do we do this today? We don't. Yet you think the powder inside the tea is going to work. Wallahi, it won't work. It's not going to work. He used to spend time with them. He used to kiss them. He used to spend time with them. Today, a lot of the husbands, they never come back home till 12 a.m. Where are they? They are with the tea seller, the butcher. They are at the cafe. They are everywhere. The filling station. They're everywhere. They don't want to come back home. What is the use of the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that teaches after Salatul Isha, go back to your home. Your wife is waiting for you. You have to spend time with her. Go back to your home. Go back, no. You don't go back home till 12 a.m. and you are tired and you're just frowning. You bash, bang the door, come inside. Where's the food? Or where's the water? I want to take bath, you know, I want to take my bath. And that's all. You go to bed next morning. Where's the breakfast? You eat breakfast and you are out. What type of a family is this? What type of a family is this? We want love in our families. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all of us. And the parents as well. And the spouses as well. We have to become really, really Islamic parents. Islam is very simple. When you don't have conviction in Allah, that is when you allow shaitan to come into your lives and he scatters the home, he breaks the home, he convinces you, uses people to convince you to do everything that is haram, thinking that your problem is going to be solved and your marriage breaks after 2 weeks. Allahu Akbar. You don't want this to happen? Look into the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Spend time with your wife. Come back home. Dress up. Spray the perfume. Eat breakfast with her. Dinner with her. Seek her advice. Show how you love her. Wallahi, she would understand because she knows you love her, and she would never ever have problem when there is no meal in the home. So many men are complaining, my wife thinks I get money from the tree or I get money from the ground. Yes, why wouldn't she think that way? There's no communication. Talk to her. Wallahi, if she knows you genuinely love her, sometimes she herself, you know, would say things like, why don't we eat, you know, a small dish today and things like that. But when you want to start making her life difficult, she would make your life twice difficult. That is it. She's gonna make your own life twice difficult. The problem sometimes is parents, especially the dads, they want to issue instruction and they want it to be followed instantly as though it is a revelation from Allah. It is not a revelation. You have to explain to them. Talk to them respectfully, then they would hear. But no, it's like kun and it is fayakun. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. You are not Allah, my beloved dad. Things has to be, we have to speak respectfully to the wives and to the kids as well. The kids of today, if you don't talk to them respectfully, it becomes a big problem. If you don't try to convince them, it becomes a big problem. You may say kun and they would be like that when you are there, but when you are not there, wallahi, it's not like that. So how would you make it to be like that when you are not there, when you have convinced them? And even if it is not like that when you are not there, they would bring themselves to you and tell you, my dad, I didn't know what happened. We have spoken. You told me not to do this. I didn't know. Shaitan overcame me. I did it. What should I do? Wow. He is coming to you. She is coming to you seeking for advice. But when she knows or he knows, you're going to shout at her, beat her up. Wallahi, she wouldn't tell you. In fact, she did it, but she would tell you she didn't do it or he didn't do it. Why? Because of the element of fear. The element of fear is there. Being good, kind, and close to your kids, it doesn't mean you are spoiling them. It doesn't mean. It doesn't mean you're spoiling them. Don't make people deceive you. They tell you, what kind of a dad are you? You're playing with your kids. The Prophet used to kiss his grandson. Subhanallah. Be kind to your kids. We haven't come to the issue of kissing your wife and so many other things. We are starting from the basic ones. Because those ones, may Allah make it easy for all of us. Gradually, it will get to that. Gradually. And when we talk about kissing your wife, we are not saying you have to broadcast it and you kiss her and everyone has to see on the social media. This also breaks the marriage. We have to know this. It's private. Your life is private. It is private. And then I know of so many mothers, so many wives, because there is no relationship between them, between her and her husband, then every day she's just looking for an opportunity to take a picture with her husband, and she posts it on WhatsApp, Instagram, and everywhere so that they see, wow, I'm going good with my husband. But when he comes to the home, it's, subhanallah, it's gloom and gloom. Subhanallah. It's gloom and doom in the home when you come sometimes. There's no communication. Speak to her. Let there be communication. She would be very happy. She wouldn't even ever think of posting your pictures because she would be scared. Man, I don't want some lady to see my husband before they start to think of something. But no, she is thinking that this would help, and instead she is inviting people. We have to understand, marital life is something that we can make very easy for ourselves, but sometimes we make it difficult. Don't care or worry yourself about what people are saying. You know what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do? Apply it. Don't worry yourself. Everyone can say what they want. Don't worry yourself. Let your kids enjoy their life in an Islamic way. In an Islamic way, they would love you, they would respect you, they would, subhanallah, they wouldn't block you on WhatsApp as well. They would let you see their statuses. May Allah help us. This is what is happening. Wallahi, I know a lot. They would be happy to let you see what is happening to them. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best from among you are those who have the best character and conduct. The best from among you are those who have the best character and conduct. This is what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. We need to develop our character and conduct and apply it in a beautiful way in our families and inside our homes. Then we would have beautiful, beautiful homes. This is what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught. Learn to correct your kids in a beautiful way. And please, very important, the parent should totally eradicate swear words inside their home. Don't abuse your kids. These days, it has a very huge psychological effect on them. Any small thing, you're crazy, you this, and all the abuses we have, so many, subhanallah, so many. Don't abuse them. Talk to them respectfully. They would love you. Wallahi, you begin to abuse them, they begin to hate you. Before it was not like that, but this generation, this is what is happening. So you have to help them. If you really love them, you should help them. If you really love them, you should do what coincides with this generation for as long as it is not against what Allah has allowed you to do. Subhanallah. The social media is there, the internet is there, Facebook, Twitter, internet, everywhere. So you think when your kids are scared of you, Don't you think they would go to the internet to seek for advice and do everything, and then the internet makes them lost and you don't even know about it, and they are there shouting, "I discipline my kids." May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our homes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really make us understand. And then when it comes to the issue, you know what, when I sit and I just look at the issue of families, there are thousands of things we can sit and keep on discussing and keep on discussing, and it never comes to an end. So many things. But the basic things I'm very passionate about is the kids. We have to help them. We have to save them. Let's not let them grow up with a lost, a bad mentality. Because they would grow up and want to do the same with their kids, and it won't help them at all. It won't help. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us, bless our kids, and grant us spouses that would be the coolness of our eyes, and bless our homes. And very, very important as well is for us to look into our homes. What do you have in your home that is making Shaitan's job easier? You have the TV. Check the channels you watch in your home. Are they bad? Are they dirty? Remove them. Remove them. And something just came to my mind, and it's very true, and it always shocks me. You go into so many homes, and then you see all these TV channels, and sometimes, I don't want to mention, but all of us know, so many homes, there is one specific channel that they watch today across the globe, especially in this part of Africa and Nigeria as well. Every place I travel, so many states, there is no state I go to, if I enter the home, 90% of the times this TV channel is there. And the kids are watching dirty, filthy, disgusting things. And then the parents are okay. But when it comes to, you see, I don't want to talk about this. Sometimes we are just deceiving our own selves. These channels, those who act the channels, act in the channels, they are not from here. Are not from here, and we are okay, we are happy, we watch and we allow the kids watch dirty, nasty, everything going wrong. But when people from here want to start acting those things, it suddenly becomes a'udhu billahi astaghfirullah, turn it off and delete it, subhanallah. But when it's them, it's normal. When it's people from here that want to start acting those things, we don't want to watch. And I'm like, subhanallah, is it not the same thing that is happening? So what is the difference? Why is it that we are trying to do things sometimes to deceive our own selves?
May Allah bless us, open our doors, grant us beautiful families, bless the parents, and bless us all. Aqul qawli hadha wa sallallahu alaihi wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanallah wa bihamdihi.